Welcome to the spoken tutorial on database and validation. In this tutorial, we will learn to interact with database and validate the fields. Here we are using Ubuntu version 12.04, NetBeans IDE 7.3, JDK 1.7, Firefox web browser 21.0. You can use any web browser of your choice. To follow this tutorial, you must have knowledge of basics of Java servlets and JSPs, connecting to MySQL database from NetBeans IDE, creating database and tables. If not, for relevant tutorials, please visit our website. Now, let us go to NetBeans IDE. I have started the MySQL server. I have created a database in it named library. I have created a table in it named users. I have already inserted some values into this table. I will show them now. For that, right click on users and click on view data. Click on the output button at the bottom. We can see that there are 15 users here. We can see the first name, surname, age, gender, email, username and password. Now, let us load the JDBC driver, that is Java Database Connectivity driver. For that, click on the Projects tab, right click on Libraries and click on Add Library. Then click on MySQL JDBC driver and click on Add Library. This will load the JDBC driver. Let us run the project as we had done earlier. Now type the username as Arya and password as Arya123*. Then click on Sign In. We can see the success greeting page. Click on here to log out. Now let us switch back to the IDE. We will go to greetingservlet.java. Come to the doPost method. First, we get the username and password from the request using getParameter method. Next, we will see the code for JDBC connection. First, we have initialized the connection object, prepared statement object and result set object to null. Then, we register the driver in our program. Then, we create a connection to the database. Then we execute the prepare statement method on the connection object. We give the query to get the user details from user's table. We check if username and password is same as that which was entered in the form. Here the question mark denotes each field in the database. To supply values in place of question mark, we execute the setString method. We do this using the prepared statement object. Then we execute the execute query method on the prepared statement object. We store the result in the result set object. For successful login, we display the success greeting page. For this, we use the request dispatcher interface. We use the get request dispatcher method on the request to obtain the request dispatcher object. We then invoke the forward method on the request dispatcher object. In this way, we forward to successgreeting.jsp. Now switch back to the slides. Let us learn something about request dispatcher interface. This interface provides the facility of dispatching the request to another resource. The resource can be HTML, servlet or JSP. Now, let us come back to the IDE. Let us come to successgreeting.jsp. Here, we are displaying the success message, "You have successfully logged in." Now, come back to the browser. Type a username and password that we have not included in the database. So, let me type ABC as the username and ABC123* as the password. Then click on Sign In. we can see that we get the error message on the same page itself. Please correct the following errors: invalid username or password. Now, let us see the code for this. So, switch back to the IDE. Go to greetingservlet.java. If the validation fails, then we should display the error message. First, we have initialized a list of error messages. We set the variable error messages into the request scope using setAttribute method. Here, error messages is the attribute name. We have initialized a string variable id to null. Then we check if the user exists in the database. If yes, we store the value in the variable id. Else, we add the error invalid username or password to error messages list. If the error messages list is not empty, then we display the error messages on index.jsp. So, we have to forward to index.jsp. We have already seen how to redirect to another page using request dispatcher. Note that we have included this code inside the try-catch block to handle exception scenarios. Now we will see how to fetch error messages variable in index.jsp. First, we obtain the value of the attribute error messages. This is done using getAttribute method on the request. Note that we have included the Java code within the opening tag, which is less than sign percentage sign and closing tag percentage sign and greater than sign. This block of code is known as scriptlet. It contains Java code which is executed every time JSP is invoked. If the value of error messages is not null, then we display this message: please correct the following errors. Then we iterate through the list of error messages. We then display the error messages as a list. This is how we display the error messages on index.jsp. Now, let us see how to add a user into the database. Before adding a user into the database, we have to create a model for the user table. Now, let us see what a model is. A model represents the underlying logical structure of data in a software application. A Java class with attributes and setters and getters for them. In this way, we can consider model as a whole instead of individual attributes. Now, switch back to NetBeans IDE. I have already created the model user.java. Note that we have created this Java class inside the package org.spokentutorial.model. We have the following attributes: first name, surname, age, gender, email, username and password. We have initialized them to empty values. Then we have a parameterized constructor. We also have a default constructor. We define the getFirstName method. We also define setFirstName method. Similarly, we define the set and get methods on each of the attributes. Come back to the browser. Now, let us click on Here link to register. Type all the fields in the registration page. Then click on Add User. We get Add User Success page. We get the message, your request to add Harshita was successful. Here, Harshita was the username that we had given. Now let us see how this is done. So switch back to the IDE. Go to addUserServlet.java. The steps are similar to that we had followed in greetingServlet.java. First, we get the form parameters using getParameter method. We initialize variable user as instance of user model with individual attributes. We set the variable user into the request scope using setAttribute method. If there are no errors while filling the form, we execute the query to insert the values into the users table. Then we forward to SuccessUser page. Now let us come to SuccessUser.jsp. Here first we have imported user.java. This line of code is called directive in JSP. A JSP directive starts with opening tag, less than sign, percentage sign and @ and ends with closing tag, percentage sign and greater than sign. This one is a page directive. The page directive contains a list of all imported packages. We get the value of the attribute user and store it as the user object. Then we have the success message here. Here we have retrieved the username. We have used getUsername method on the request object. We have done this using scriptlet tags. Now let us come back to the browser. We will try to add the user already present in the database. So I will try to add Harshita again. We can see that we get the error message, please correct the following errors, duplicate entry Harshita for key username. Now let us register for a user once again. Here I have filled up the form now. I have created a mistake in the age field. I have typed AB instead of a valid number. Now click on add user. We see we get the error message, the age must be a positive integer. Now let us see how this is done. Switch back to the IDE. Open addUserServlet.java. Here also we have created a list of error messages. Then we set the variable error messages into the request scope using setAttribute method. Then we have declared age user of type integer and we have initialized it to -1. Inside the try-catch block, we have used parseInt method. This will return an integer given a string representation of numbers as input. So here, we validate that the age field contains a valid positive integer. If the validation fails, then we add the error message to error messages list. The age must be a positive integer. Similarly, we have to validate all other fields to have valid data. If the error messages list is not empty, then we will display the error messages on addUser.jsp itself. We have already seen how to do this using requestDispatcher. Now, let us come to addUser.jsp. Here also, first we have imported user.java. Inside the scriptlet tags, we have created an object of type user. Then we get the value of the attribute error messages using getAttribute method. We check if this value is equal to null. If it is not equal to null, then we display the error message just as we had done for index.jsp. If not, we will get the value of the attribute user from request using user model. Then we have the form. The form tag has action as addUserServlet and method as post. The first field is first name of input type as text, name as first name and value as user.getFirstName. Here we are initializing the value of first name to empty string. Similarly, you have to do for other fields. We also have a submit button and value as addUser. This is how we validate the fields in addUser.jsp. You can try out different errors on addUser page. Now, let us see if the user Harshita has been added to the database. So, come back to the users table. We can see that Harshita is added to the database. In this tutorial, we have learned database connectivity and field validation. To know more about the spoken tutorial project, watch the video available at the following link. It summarizes the spoken tutorial project. If you do not have good bandwidth, you can download and watch it. The Spoken Tutorial Project team conducts workshops using Spoken Tutorials, gives certificates to those who pass an online test. For more details, please write to contact@spoken-tutorial.org. Spoken Tutorial Project is a part of Talk to a Teacher project. It is supported by the National Mission on Education through ICT, MHRD, Government of India. More information on this mission is available at spoken-tutorial.org/nmeict-intro. The library management system has been contributed by a leading software MNC through their Corporate Social Responsibility Program. They have also validated the content for the spoken tutorial. This is Arya Ratish from IIT Bombay signing off. Thank you for joining.